the western end. So I'll take a walk down there. Some of the top boards seem to have a problem, and it looks like there's a little bit of dipping on that corner. Let's have a closer look. Now this looks to me like the land is dipping a little bit, so I would assume that's a little bit of erosion. I'm no expert on that, but there might be a breach in the corrugated plastic. Just for reference, for all intents and purposes, it's the same water level all the way along our wall. You can see that parts of the far wall are quite high above the water level. And of course, a good reference is that the water level is not coming up under the docks. So let's have a closer look. There's definitely some dipping, but it's not dramatic. Here we've lost the top board. And we're exposing the, for lack of a better term, the corrugated plastic sheeting. And here also. But we're comfortably, the water is comfortably away from the top of the wall. Now there's something going on over there with the ground. Let's go have a closer look. There's no telling what this is, but this is not a healthy lawn. I imagine during storms, the water comes up over this area. You can see there's almost a trench along the back. Again, we've exposed that plastic corrugated, but this seems to be fairly even up to the dock. Definitely erosion going on. That fill is going somewhere, so there's probably a breach in the wall below water level. Here we are at the docks, and you can see the water is well away from the docks. I'm standing at the beginning of the western dock, and things don't look too bad here. There's a very large divot up ahead, which is connected to a storm drain that starts in our parking area. The board is trying to determine the best approach for this, because this is the HOA's responsibility. Definitely some sort of erosion. It's a very deep pothole. Again, definitely the signs of erosion. That fill, that earth must be being washed out at quite a rate. And I believe David, our president, It's called B.E. Singleton to correct this, straighten it out, and probably add a piling. You can see the wall up ahead is obviously not at the same level all the way through. So behind the first unit, you can see sand. It's no longer supporting turf, and it's very, very low. So any sort of surge in the height of our water level, that area gets soaked and you get more erosion. Looking back at where I was, let me turn this around. Looking back at where I was, you can see the corner dipping. So there's definitely some sort of sinking or erosion going on with that wall. As you can see, I'm past the eastern dock, and this is the wall that I was referring to. You can see a great deal of erosion here, where turf can't be sustained. And there's another pretty bad spot up ahead. So, turf is unsustainable here. Let's have a look at that area. Worse than the other area. That fill is going somewhere. This is absolutely barren. Thanks to our recent stretch of dry, sunny weather, this is all dry. But as you can see, there are many days when the rains come back where it's impossible to walk here. You're essentially trudging through the water. That continues all along this section of the wall, which I guess you would call the south section. And finally, this eastern corner is just crumbling into the river. And quite often it's impossible to walk on this lawn.